Mr. Pollard?
Yes. I'm sorry. I had to run to the store.
That's okay. I'm Lacey, and this is my husband, Daniel.
You said on the phone you have two children.
Yes, we were just thinking that it was better maybe if we met you first and then. Thank you.
Have a seat in the living room. I'll put on some tea. Cats don't seem to care about them. I used to live in the suburbs, but the dogs always barked at night when they came around. Dogs have a sense for them. Kept me up at night, so I moved here to a building that doesn't allow dogs. Helps me sleep a little better at night. I don't fight them anymore.
Them?
The Grays. That's what they're called. There are three generally accepted kinds of aliens. The Grays, insectoids, and the reptilians. But 9 times out of 10, what people report seeing are the Grays. In fact, I'm dubious about the other two altogether, especially the reptilians. I don't think those accounts are credible.
Yeah, that would make anyone skeptical.
I'm sorry, getting ahead of myself. The first thing we need to do is determine whether or not you actually are experiencing an encounter.
Is that a test?
Just a series of questions. Helps weed out the lunatics.
Good. Let's do it.
Okay. Have either of you seen any bright lights in the sky above your neighborhood that moved in an unusual way?
No.
Have you experienced any severe headaches or migraines?
Nope.
Either of you heard a ringing in your ears that seems to be happening only inside your head?
Yes.
Have you experienced any unexplained illnesses? Strange allergies or nosebleeds?
Yes.
Yes.
Have you witnessed any abnormal behavior by animals in your neighborhood?
3 different flocks of birds flew into our house the other day.
I would say that qualifies. Have either of you experienced any blackouts, stretches of time that you can't account for? And have you experienced the feeling that you might not be in control of your own body?
How do you know all this?
You are not alone in this. Others have experienced what you're going through and have struggled the way you're struggling now.
Why are the Grays, or whatever they are, so interested in us? What makes us so special?
Nothing. There's nothing special about you. I'm sorry. You were hoping for a different answer. But this is beyond our comprehension. What answer would a lab rat understand from a scientist in a white coat putting electrodes in its brain, giving it cancer? I've interviewed literally thousands of people who claim to have been visited by the Greys. They come from all walks of life. The only thing they have in common is that their lives have become a living hell because of it. People think of aliens as these beings invading our planet in some great cataclysm, destroying monuments, stealing our natural resources. But it's not like that at all. The invasion already happened. No one knows exactly when, but they're here. They've been here. The presence of the Greys is now a fact of life, like death and taxes.
Do you know what they want?
They seem to be studying us, experimenting on us. One thing we know for sure is they use our fears against us. It can start like a childish prank. A mess in the kitchen, or things missing in the house. And before you know it, you're walking through a full-blown nightmare. You probably already have implants.
Implants?
That's how they control you. Make you do things you can't remember. Make you see things that aren't there. Should we have a look?
Yes.
Let me see. Yeah, there she is. This one didn't take as well. Skin's pretty irritated, that happens sometimes.
It's a rash or a bite.
That's what they want you to think. The Greys hide what they do. Disguise the implants as something perfectly normal. Most people don't even know they have them.
Well, can we remove it?
No. No, believe me, I've tried.
Oh my God.
Every time I think I'm getting it, it seems to burrow in deeper.